Hey, good afternoon, everybody. This is Chef Jackson Lamb. I'm talking today about Chapter 6, Food Safety. This is one of the most important chapters that you're going to go over. Let me discuss a couple of things that you need to really know about food safety. Number one, we need to know how to handle food properly. It begins with personal hygiene. It really begins with knowing how to wash your hands properly. And I'll do a little demo while I'm talking to you here. You know, typically when we go to the sink, what the Board of Health would like to see is that we put soap on our hands, we go ahead and we wash, and we should wash our hands as long as it takes to sing the song, Happy Birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. You get the idea. But as we wash our hands, it all begins there. You know, if we're working in a kitchen environment and we have to go and put gloves on, great. We would put gloves on at this point in time. We would get into our workstation and then we would start doing our tasks. If for some reason we need to take those gloves off, the Board of Health wants us to re-wash our hands. You know, once when I was the chef at Rose Medical Center, I was making chicken parmesan from scratch, 150 chicken breasts. So can you imagine this? Here's a raw chicken breast. I need to dip it in flour, egg, breadcrumbs, and then I need to saute it until it's 165 to 170 degrees on a flat top griddle. I had so many clumps on my fingers, I had to change my gloves 12 times. But that's what the Board of Health likes to see. Other food safety issues, we want to make sure that we're keeping hot food hot. We want to make sure that we're keeping cold food cold. And to learn all these rules and regulations, you're going to go through ServSafe Certification. ServSafe is a national program that's sponsored by the National Restaurant Association. And as you get into ServSafe, you'll realize on their website, there's about five different certifications that they offer. They offer ServSafe Food Handler Certification. They offer ServSafe Food Allergen. Great, great certification to have. Food Allergen Certification. The state of California actually has their own certification. It's called ServSafe California, believe it or not. There's also ServSafe Manager Certification. And so the difference between Manager Certification and Food Handler Certification, well, the difference is about 100 questions, and the difference is also about $100. So as a result, working with ServSafe basically gives us a national certification that we've been trained properly in the safe handling of food. Here's a tidbit of information. Should you have a student that does not have a social security number? I had this incident last semester. I had a student that says, hey, I don't have a social security number. I can't sign up and take the ServSafe test. Well, we found an alternative for that. A lot of ServSafe certifications are sponsored by ANSI, which is a National Safety Institute. And so here we go, just going to show you this real quick. This certification I found the certification and had my student pursue this. Why doesn't that student have a social security number? Possibly a DACA or Dreamer student. And as a result, at Metropolitan State University of Denver, we have an entire department dedicated to helping DACA and Dreamers be successful in their college years. And so as a result, we find a way for everything at Metro State University. Hopefully you'll find a way of success in your local high school as well. Chef Jackson Lamb, I could talk for hours about food safety, but it's more important that you spend that time looking at these certification process with ServSafe. Depending on which school you're in, you may be going after ServSafe Food Handler, or you may be doing ServSafe Manager. Both are terrific certifications to have. Food Handler lasts for 3 years, Manager lasts for 5 years. You'll be a manager before you know it. Chef Jackson Lamb signing off, talking about food safety. Thanks a lot, everybody.